Welcome back, everyone. Few things beat Chinese takeout, but all those added calories and fat and unhealthy ingredients can pack a punch to our waistline. So, back to Fake Out, a healthy version of Mongolian beef. Chinese takeout is the author of The Wellness Project. Please welcome back Phoebe LaPine. Welcome, Phoebe.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Very excited about this. You and I eat very similarly. We got to point out Hallmark Movies and Mystery Star Christopher Pulaha stuck around because he wanted to find out how you can have Mongolian beef at half the calories. Am I right?
Yes.
Debbie, Kim, Ken, also at the counter want to find out the same thing.
So good, baby.
Debbie, you've gone in already.
Are we just doing it?
Yeah, just dig in.
So, I mean, we all know that the sauce for Mongolian beef. So tasty, of course, but can be a lot of hidden sugar, can be MSG, can be a lot of unhealthy fats. You figured out a way to make this sauce with all the flavor, gluten-free, grain-free.
Grain-free, that's really rare. Okay, so Chinese food, a lot of sugar, as you mentioned.
Yes.
Also a lot of cornstarch, which can bother some people. I have an autoimmune disease, I'm gluten-free, and then, you know, corn can be a little bit irritating for me, too. So we're using arrowroot starch.
I like it already.
Anyone ever cooked with that?
Yes, interesting.
Okay, that's a healthy substitute. So a lot of these things that we're going to be hearing here are just substitutes. It's not like you're taking something out of the sauce. Mm-hmm. It's just instead of this, you use this. For instance, the arrowroot starch.
So this is great in baked goods as a binder. It's also great for thickening sauces, like in your Chinese food.
Okay.
And it comes from a tropical plant that's kind of similar to cassava root. And we're basically just going to start by creating a little slurry with some room temperature liquid. In this case, chicken stock, but you can use water or what have you. And then we're just going to build our sauce from here. So we are also using gluten-free tamari, which is very similar to soy sauce. So if you don't care and, you know, don't have a sensitivity, you can definitely use regular soy
But the reason why you would use this is because, and I like this point, is because there's no wheat in tamari sauce, right?
Yeah.
Typically, soy sauce has some wheat in there.
Exactly.
Okay, so keeping it wheat-free.
Exactly. So then the next ingredient, maple syrup. So again, lots of sugar, usually brown sugar in this sauce. And I like to use maple syrup because, you know, it's a natural substitute, but it's also kind of has a lower percentage of fructose, so it's a little easier on your blood sugar. Yeah.
In our house, we swap out sugar for maple syrup all the time.
Well, you're Canadian.
You know, I love it. I actually forgot that. It probably is partially because I'm Canadian.
Well. All right, so little garlic.
Okay,
oh, you
want to
give me a zhuzh there?
Yeah. I'll work on the garlic.
Okay, perfect. Then ginger. Can't have Mongolian beef without some fresh ginger
root. Very good.
And then again, to balance the sweet, we're just going to do a touch of spicy. So a bit of red chili flakes.
Awesome. Okay, great. So we're working on the tamari sauce
here. So you whisk that together.
I will.
I have already browned the beef, and we'll talk about that in a second.
Okay.
But I'm just going to also get our broccoli down in here.
Very
since
good.
It is a stir fry.
Now, how about the oil that you use when you're talking about browning the beef or sauteing the broccoli?
So we also use a little bit of arrowroot starch with the beef, just a little bit of a dredging, which gives it that beautiful brown crust. And we use flank steak today. You can use skirt steak, you can use boneless short ribs, which is very common. And so we use coconut oil, which is one of my favorite healthy fats.
Exactly right. Mm-hmm.
And there's nothing wrong with olive oil, there's nothing wrong with some vegetable oils. For me, it's all in how you use it. So olive oil is fantastic in salad dressings, very heart healthy. But when you use it on a high temperature, as you do with a stir fry, then it tends to break down. And coconut oil is great. It has a lot of health benefits. But for cooking especially, it is a high burning temperature. So
it's the refined or the virgin?
It kind of doesn't matter.
Okay.
Depends on the flavor.
That's fine. Great.
Unrefined, you can have a little bit more of a coconutty flavor. For this, like kind of Asian cuisine, again, you
it
don't
sort of
mind
works.
That. It
yeah.
works.
Okay, good.
Exactly like regular Mongolian
meat. Oh, good.
Meat.
That's it's a fake out.
This can't be a fake out.
It's a real fake out.
It's legit. This.
Okay, so now you've put the sauce on. You've reduced it a little bit over there, I see. We're sauteing the broccoli in our nice healthy fat of coconut oil. Brown the beef, and then we just add this to the now reduced tamari sauce.
Yes,
is that the
so
idea?
We are about to get this into this sauce.
Okay.
You can see it's thickened up really beautifully. Wow.
Okay.
So if you want to get the beef down in here,
so just,
go for it.
Pop it right in there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're doing so well, by the way. You're an excellent cook.
See, I'm starting to believe it now.
We never
That's the problem.
Yeah.
That's the problem. Once I I start believing it, it's all going to go downhill.
Cameron,
really?
Cameron, standing right here.
I'm sorry.
I totally heard you.
You were there.
So I'm just going to transfer this here. This dish is super quick. Obviously, we had a little help behind the scenes.
Yep.
But still, the whole thing comes together in less than 15 minutes, which is great for a weeknight meal. And honestly, it's kind of faster than takeout.
That's
gonna argue that.
Than Chinese takeout. Right. You make it
a 45 minutes to get it to your house.
And it comes
exactly.
I know.
It's cool.
And I don't want to tip.
Yeah. Did that come out?
Wow. Wow. It came out again. Oh, it came out. The filter is not here today.
It's
Kim.
It's
oh, my gosh.
Sorry.
Okay, so you just kind of fold that in there
and
you get
beautiful.
The sauce.
Yeah, and then you just cook it for, you know, a minute longer to let all the flavors meld together. But we, you know, we're kind of ready.
A little bit.
Did you think this is gluten-free?
It's gluten-free. It's grain-free. We're serving it, obviously, over brown rice, but you can do cauliflower rice if you want to keep it totally paleo. I like to do gluten-free ramen.
Oh, interesting. I didn't even know there was gluten-free
twist.
Ramen.
I didn't know that either. I thought I knew
it all.
Can
you make that next time you're here?
Uh-huh. Yeah, that'll change your life. Not going to lie.
You know, can I just point something out about Phoebe? I don't know if you all remember or know this about her. The reason that she is such an amazing chef, home cook, is because this happened because she had to.
Why?
She had an autoimmune disease called Hashimoto's, correct? And she was sick, and she kept going to the doctors, and they said, nothing's wrong with you. But every time she'd eat, her stomach would bloat.
What? It's true. It's all true.
And she kind of diagnosed herself, and then finally the doctors jumped on board and said, yes, you're right. There's something wrong.
And the successful treatment for you, in large part, was changing your diet like this.
Exactly. Taking gluten out was a huge lifesaver in a way, really brought me up to a bigger plateau. And then I also changed a lot of other lifestyle things I talk about in my book, from my sleep habits to my hydration, and it kind of all adds together little by little to completely make over your life.
Food is medicine, and if this is medicine, I'm a happy guy.
Okay, don't forget your scallions. Mm. They're beautiful.
Would you like to taste this to see how well Cameron did?
Yes.
I worked hard on this,
TV.
The least you can do is take a taste.
For sure.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you, Phoebe. Honestly, you're very inspiring.
Did you do all right?
Cameron.
Yeah. Wow. I'm very tired. I'm very tired for everybody. Thank you.
Good job, Phoebe.
HallmarkChannel.com, and you can connect with Phoebe on her website, feedmephoebe.com. I love the name of that.
Oh.
And be sure to watch this guy next to me, Christopher Polaha, in Mystery 101 on Sunday, January 27th at 9, 8 Central on our sister network, Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. Did you enjoy your early lunch?
I loved the Mongolian beef. Look at my plate is empty.
There you go. Beautiful. Stop by whenever you want. We'll always feed you.
All right,
promise
deal.
That.